You're watching The Robert Christian Show.
Away from the office, if you can imagine that, maybe we'll get the chance to do just that this weekend. So once again, I do want to thank everybody for tuning in, and of course, I want to thank Andrew for his help today. Actually, he is actually cloning or mirroring the new stream on the old stream. Today. So we are letting people know once and again, just in case that they missed it, that the actual stream location has changed. However, we are doing what we can, folks, to get everybody on board and everybody up to date with what's kind of going on in your world. So as we begin, folks, I've got news. Breaking news, actually, that came in this morning from Austin, Texas. Thousands of people streamed off of the University of Texas campus on Friday in Austin after a phoned-in bomb threat apparently promoted an evacuation of all of the buildings, and officials have warned students and the faculty to get out and as far away, apparently, as possible. No explosive devices, however, have been found as of midday. The university received a call about 8:35 a.m. from a man claiming to be with Al-Qaeda, who said that he had placed these explosives all over a 50,000 student campus, according to the University of Texas spokeswoman Rhonda Wilden. He claimed that these devices would go off in 90 minutes and all buildings were evacuated at 9:50 a.m. as a precaution. So far, nothing has happened. However, there is even more news with this, because if it wasn't just for the University of Texas there at Austin, the University of North Dakota also received very similar threats today. You know what? I was very taken by that news story, and that is still being discovered and uncovered. So as breaking news does happen with that, we'll at least be able to share that as well. I don't know what it is, honestly, about people where they feel that they have no absolute, seriously, no reason to cause heartache, to cause panic, to cause any of this stuff. I don't get it. I simply do not understand it. And the person that made that call in, I honestly hope that they are caught. What do you all think? Do you guys agree with me? They need to be caught. That's exactly what I think. I'm looking, folks, at the most reasonable answer. But if it wasn't one university, one major university, another university also. And that was as of this morning. Good grief. Hey, and in other news, those that are within the Occupy Wall Street group, do me a favor and come out of the closet, right? I don't want you to be lurking. I want you to come out of the closet and say, hey, we're here. Hey, I'm here. Because I have news for you. Which is interesting, and I really would like to get an occupiers or somebody that supports the Occupy movement, their opinion on this. Now, as of Monday, this upcoming Monday, a big announcement, right? The Occupy Wall Street group in New York will be celebrating their first year of their occupation. However, what have we learned in the last year? when it came to the Occupy Wall Street movement, when it comes to their message, when it comes to what they have been voicing, how loud has their voice been? And realistically, again, looking at the Occupy Wall Street movement versus and being a leaderless movement, here they are, folks. They are planning on a protest to commemorate the first protest. Maybe a reenactment. I don't know. But the original message, and I've got to say it because I've said it before and I will say it again. The original message of the Occupy, that is what I personally agree with. Standing against corporate greed. I have no problem with that. However, where I do have a problem is that when the occupiers and or those in and around the Occupy group, where they have a tendency to want to start causing violence, that is not cool. That is unjust. We have enough of that in the world today, and we're going to be going into it. Can you say, can anybody, do you have the audacity to type in the chat box on the stream? Anti-Islam film that has caused international havoc, and we're going to be getting into it. Remember, the producer of that film, which is in Southern California, apparently outside of Los Angeles, has apparently gone into hiding. Oh, I bet he has. We're going to be going into that story because, you know what, the world that we live in does not have to be so cut and dry. It's either, violent or to the point of violence. It should not come to that. But what is it that incites violence in people? I really would like your thought on it. What incites that violence? What incites the hatred for humanity? I was completely blown away. Folks, if it wasn't enough, if it was not enough that the two universities received the same kind of threat this morning, and on the heels of this B-rated movie, wherein the actors and actresses apparently were lied to. They were not told the truth as to what the movie. Look, Islam is a religious oracle. The religious rite or the religious fundamental faith of some. But that doesn't mean that everyone that is within the Islamic nation or the Islamic faith is wrong or is horrible people. If you want to look at horrible people, people that really don't care, it doesn't take a brain scientist, right, to figure out who they are. Now, I'm not going to stand up for any one person or any one religion, but I am going to stand up for freedom of religion. I am going to stand up for the freedom of the press. I am going to stand up for what the right of it is. But when a movie producer goes out of his way to make sure that his movie, Anti-Islam, makes the airwaves. Oh, and big number. I mean, how else? If you're a B-rated a TV producer or a B-rated movie producer, how else are you going to be able to get the airtime around the world for your movie unless it is surely going to cause havoc? The Middle East right now is erupting in violent acts from Cairo to I could imagine even in Israel and beyond. Look at Libya. The violence and the violent act of others, you know, folks, it's crazy. It is absolutely repulsive. Now, again, what gives? I simply do not understand this. As the news story says, several protests are stemming, at least in part, from an anti-Islam film produced in the United States, are unfolding outside of U.S. embassies around the world. Friday's protest follow one Tuesday at the U.S. embassy in Cairo. And the U.S. consulate in, let's say, where attacks were killed, the U.S. ambassador to Libya, and three other Americans. The Nicaraguan military and police fired shots to disperse a crowd of protesters in the city of Jos. An eyewitness has also said about 2,000 people protesting anti-Islamic film gathered at a central mosque, and security forces intervened with when the crowd started moving toward the city center. At 12:15 p.m. Eastern Time today, some protesters scaled the gates of a U.S. embassy in Tennis and reached the garden outside of the building, but have not yet breached the building itself, according to a journalist report. In Afghanistan, hundreds of demonstrators in the eastern province burned a U.S. flag and chanted "Death to America," and "We condemn the film." The demonstration lasted about an hour and ended peacefully. A local official said the Afghan government has ordered an infinite block of YouTube to prevent people from watching the clips and staging protests and violent protests. In Baghdad, Iraq, hundreds of followers of the radical Shiite Muslim cleric said no to America and no to Israel. Now, folks, I look at stories like that, and yes, it is, it's heartbreaking. I am appalled. I am very upset, actually, because the act of one has incited violence of thousands. The act of one. Now, this producer may or may not have meant for this to go the way that it did. He may or may not support the Nation of Islam. However, this is the United States. And granted, there are a lot of movies that depict war and depict violence. There are a lot of video games that do the same. And who is calling the shots with the ESRB? Who is calling the shots on these video game platforms? Again, folks, if it's not one thing, it's going to be something completely different. And you know what? I don't know. I simply do not understand why that this happens. Wow. Folks, we're going to be getting into a little bit more of that news story. As crazy as that it is. All right. Now, another news story from Western Washington. Let me actually find it. I think it was over on this side of my page. Let me actually see. Where did it go? Where did they put it? Let's see. Oh, yes. And so far, according to the news, one person was killed as a direct result of that film. And we're going to be going back into that. But for those in Western Washington, wow, let me actually find it. The news story. Let me see. Here we go. This is a very interesting news story. For those of you that know where Auburn, Washington is, just south of Seattle. Auburn, apparently, the city of Auburn has created an online wall of shame to put pressure on banks holding mortgages on homes that were foreclosed on because these banks are not taking care of the property. The site lists properties that need work, including a picture and the names of banks that hold the property and contact information. Isn't that something? The banks apparently were reached out to and stated that they knew the ownership of the property had been transferred and they maintained the properties. However, Auburn, Washington Mayor Peter Lewis said that it is taking too long for the work to get done. Lewis actually bikes around the city taking pictures of these properties to post this on the wall of shame. The site also explains the mortgage holders are out-of-state financial institutions who are slow to respond and have hired property preservation companies, okay, who are not consistent with their maintenance services. Okay. Now, this is interesting, and some of you will probably get a good belly laugh. And we should. Somebody says this. Where is the Occupy Wall Street Seattle gang when you need them? End quotation. Rolling on the floor laughing. Remember, when they broke into a house and just took it over because it was just sitting there? Wow, Auburn. Although I agree, these banks should take care of this property. Nonetheless, I cannot... let's see. Nonetheless, they did not want the homeowners in there taking care of it because they missed payments. Yet the bank wanted it back to do nothing with it. So comes the Occupy group. Can you say Occupy Auburn is now born? Rolling on the floor laughing. Yeah, so hey, if people want to get into a house and occupy it, surely, Auburn, Washington might be the place to be. Okay. Going into this this story of the University of Texas at Austin, they are saying now that the threat has actually ended. However, the classes for today have been dismissed. So that part's good news. But I wonder, folks, what does it take, really, to bring somebody, anybody, to a breaking point where they want nothing more to incite violence on another human being? What is it about a group? What is it about a person? Now, granted, we can protest a lot of things. We can demonstrate a lot of things. However, when is enough enough? When is enough bureaucracy? When is enough violence enough? And again, what does it take for someone to jump off the deep end? And to do that. Now, here is a challenge for those Occupy Wall Street streams. And I would bet you dollars to donuts that they are not going to, they're not going to do this. But you could go to a lot of streams. And a lot of these streams have thousands of people that have been banned from their streams, banned from speaking their mind because of a challenge that they have brought. For speaking their mind, they are banned. Now, as of Monday, the first year anniversary of the Occupy Wall Street group, I would really like to see these streams. Seriously, take off these bans from all of these people that they didn't like. Because somebody else actually maybe spoke a ray of truth that maybe you didn't want to hear. You see, folks, that is where we lost viewership. We did. When I outright said, and folks, I will say it again, that this show does not support and we cannot endorse the Occupy group. If we did, then that would mean that we would have to endorse every other radical and or violent group and or any other group that there is. I personally, as an individual, and I can always say it as an individual, I support the Occupy group for what that its original message was. Standing against corporate greed. I have no problem with that. The problem that I have is the violence. The problem that I have is inciting and trying to get police activity and trying to push the envelope just a little bit to see how far that they can actually push the envelope. And then they get mad when the envelope is pushed back. Folks, to me, that's ridiculous. But the original message, standing against corporate greed, yes, I agree with that. I think that was a fantastic idea, a flawless message. However, the way that it was addressed, the way that it has become, you know, the Occupy group in a year has so changed. But yet it is leaderless. Now I want to look for just a moment in time before we take a short break and say this. That even Martin Luther King, Dr. Martin Luther King, his message, his I Have a Dream speech, that message forever, will it ever be echoed through the bellows of time in the United States and around the world. He and that movement was not leaderless, but yet it was a civil unrest. And he brought to the platform his idea that every man should be treated equally and not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their heart. How much more truth is that message? And does it resonate than it does today? That was extremely timely. Now, unlike the Occupy Wall Street movement that doesn't have a solid baseline as far as membership, it's dwindling. It has been dwindling. The message has become very violent, unlike Dr. Martin Luther King. Now, again, in every civil unrest in the United States, ever in its history, there's always been violence. There's always been something going on. However, what message is going to resonate more truth? What message is going to resonate fear? Is it the Occupy Wall Street group that is going to resonate fear? Or did everybody fear Dr. Martin Luther King's message when he said, I have a dream? I think a lot of people even feared his message because they did not like the idea of African Americans finally standing up and saying, you know what, I've had enough. And you know what, the doctor is right. What about Miss Parks in Birmingham, Alabama, when she refused to get in the back of the bus? How many times have you been told, folks, to get in the back of the bus? Because of your disability. Ooh, because of your income inequality. How about that? What do you think? Folks, this is a time, this is an era that we live in that unfortunately has a lot of anger, a lot of violence. But again, going back to the point, clearly, what does it take to get somebody, to get anyone, to feel that their only option is violence? Is it that people take great joy, they take great pride in violence? They take great joy and great pride knowing that they have caused violence, or that they have shut the city down for a day, or a college as of today, two of them. I don't get it. Folks, this is the Robert Christian Show. We're going to take a short break, and we will return. Don't go away. Have a computer problem? Visit thetechnologist.biz. Andrew Epperson has 13-plus years of experience in the IT support area, offering initial computer setup, virus and malware removal, migrating your data to the cloud, and more. Help your employer design a cost-effective telecommuting solution, and you can do it all from home. Still have questions? Email thetechnologist at andrew@thetechnologist.biz. The Technologist, a proud sponsor of The Robert Christian Show. All right, folks, and that is for Andrew. And I want to take this opportunity, folks, to again welcome everyone to the stream today. And I really would like everybody, or as many as feasibly possible, really, to let me know what you all think. Now, we're talking about violence. We're talking about violent acts of others. And these violent acts that are too often portrayed upon everyone else. And what does it take to set somebody off? And why do they feel that their option and their only option is violence? Folks, we're going to be getting into the story of this anti-Islam film right after our break. But I do want to leave you first with this note before we do go to break. That I personally have zero opinion on the Islamic faith. Zero. Because that faith, as with any other religious oracle, look at the ones in the United States, even. Not just the Nation of Islam. All right? Not just them. But look at a lot of the right-wing fundamental religious organizations and groups in the United States. You go to church on Sunday, supposed to be a place where hurting people can be healed, a place where joy invades the camp, right? Where happiness enters into someone's heart, and they hear a message that is of love, of hope, of gentleness, of mercy. That's what you would think. But too often, you find messages that are behind the pulpit on Sunday, and these messages are based on this is who to hate and this is why. This is who we've got to hate. We've got to completely disrupt their life with hatred. And we have to continue having the discussion on dividing America and dividing faiths. And anybody that does not believe like you do, you're going to immediately hate them. That is a far right-wing Christianity. Very judgmental, very hateful. And folks, that's not the way that it is supposed to be. In the real world, beyond the walls of a church, in the real world, beyond the confounds of a religious organization or a religious faith, no one no matter what, no one deserves to be entreated with inequality. No one deserves the anger, the backlash. Nobody deserves this. Not one group. Now, you may not agree with that group, but that's your personal opinion. But folks, when your personal opinion becomes someone else's vision, then you're in trouble. My personal opinion can't be your dream. Your dream, your aspiration for life, your aspiration for peace and for happiness, should not be based on mine. What you feel in your heart, what you feel in your very spirit, down where you live, down where you are, that alone should incite peace and joy. That alone should instill a ray of hope for all of humanity, that everyone would be able to get along, and that everyone would be able to say, you know what, just because they're a little bit different doesn't mean that I have to hate them. There are too many groups, trust me, that are out there that are hateful, extremely hateful. And folks, it is time really to get beyond that. So I want to know from your mouth today, really, what is it that incites people and brings people to the point of hatred? Outlandish hatred. What is it? Is it the fear of the unknown? Is it the fear and thinking, well, maybe this group is, maybe they have something right? Maybe I'm going to fear my neighbor because they are Muslim. Maybe I'm going to fear my neighbor because they're Pentecostal. I'm going to fear and I'm going to hate my neighbor because they're Baptist or because they are the Church of Christ. They go there. Or maybe because they're Methodist. Or I'm going to really hate them because they're Catholic. No matter what they actually do in the community, no matter how they live their life, based on their religious faith, their religious fundamental, based on that, I'm going to hate them. I.e., folks, look at this director of this B-rated movie, right? Look at what he did. Like I said, it's all right not to like somebody. It's all right not to like something. But just because you don't like it doesn't mean you have to hate it. I like to understand, and I really want to challenge you. Where you are, where you live. I want to challenge you, folks, to look at the truth of it. Look at the reality of it. Now, if it were someone coming against your personal religious fundamentals, if you're Islam, if you're Baptist, if you're Catholic, whatever that you are, would it not make you a little bit offended if someone was to come against you for your religious beliefs? Now, the religious morals are completely different. Some religious organizations, their message is a message of hate to begin with. But that message is one that needs to be changed. Living in a hateful society, in a hateful world, folks, that's one thing. And we find hate around every corner. Trust me. And now we have this movie, that this B-rated movie that came out, and the actors not even really being fully aware as to the nature of the movie. The movie is getting worldwide publicity. And now YouTube has blocked some of it, the content. And I think it's for a good reason. I think it's for a very good reason. So folks, I'm quite appalled. This is Friday. a day that we should be looking forward to the weekend. But what has happened is that in a lot of cities worldwide, there is anger, there is violence being portrayed and being blasted on U.S. territory. The consulates in various countries. And people from these other religious beliefs or these other these other nations around the world completely coming against the United States and saying, you know what, hey, the U.S. could have done something about it to stop it. And so what gives? Even Mitt Romney, even his team, as of this morning said, if President Romney, oh boy, if he was in the White House, this never would have happened. But because it was President Barack Obama, surely it did. And so, hey, they're trying to cast the blame on President Obama. You know what? That doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Folks, we're going to be going to break at 36 past. Don't go away.
Hey folks, I'm Robert Christian with The Robert Christian Show. Join us Monday through Friday right here for The Robert Christian Show as we discover news, breaking news, politics, religion, you name it. Folks, we have an incredible opportunity, a dynamic opportunity right now to use social media at its best. So we invite you to use your social media, folks, and go to YouTube, type in The Robert Christian Show. Hey, we're also on Twitter. You can find us there at News Talk 2. Folks, we are everywhere. Visit us on our website, www.robertchristianshow.com, and see what we're about, folks. We have an incredible opportunity right now, and I want to encourage you to take this opportunity, folks, to get involved beyond the social realm of social media and get involved in your media. Folks, this is the Robert Christian Show, where your voice and your opinion, they matter.
All right, folks, and we are back. We can be followed, folks, that would like to know, on Twitter, at the Robert Christian Show. There is our hashtag. Also, we are on Facebook, folks. Robert Christian Show, you can find us there also, and do follow us on Skype, folks. We are there as well. Hey, folks, we are everywhere. So if you would like to tune in, folks, and you would like to voice your opinion, you can locate us on Skype at News Talk, and then the number 2. All right, going into the subject matter today, and as much as that I do not really like going into it, but talking about the violent acts of other people and citing violence on United States-owned consulates, buildings, and now the death of at least one because of a movie, a B-rated movie. You know, I was taken back a lot because let's for a minute talk about religion. Folks, the religious organization that I grew up in, and the home that I personally grew up in, it was a religious home. It wasn't a God-fearing home. I was raised in a religious oracle or religious organization that was governed by one man. And I'm not talking about the Catholic Church either, but the equivalent. And we were told and we were taught growing up that celebrating Christmas and Easter, birthdays, it was all wrong. Everybody was wrong. And everybody that wasn't like them was not, in quotation, converted. And they used it in a very perverted way. And they did not like their church members to be watching television on Saturday, Friday night to Saturday night. No television whatsoever. Although you could go out to eat, of course, but if you're lucky enough. But it was more or less a one-man show. And it was based on Old Testament theology, not on the New Testament. It was built on an idea that everybody else was wrong and we are the only ones that are right. And they would pride themselves by saying, look, we are the only true church. We're it. And because we're it, you've got to pay attention. Hey, if you like it or not, we're it. Now, how many of you have ever been raised in a religious organization, a church like that? That's what I would like to know. Too many people are so enslaved by a religious fundamental or a religious idea. And simply put, it's horrible. It's horrifying. Now, there's a lot of unanswered questions for Americans, including a U.S. ambassador to Libya, Chris Stevens, were killed on Tuesday as gunmen set fire and fought security forces at the U.S. consulate there in Libya. The attack came as protesters outside the compound rallied against the movie that unflatteringly portrays Islam's Prophet Muhammad. But the news article says that we are starting to get a clearer picture of what had happened and why. But many more important and larger questions about the attack in Libya that still remained unanswered. Who exactly is behind the attacks and what was their motivation? According to this news report, the attack from the people with guns and rocket-propelled grenades came as people were protesting an anti-Islamic video outside the United States consulate on Tuesday night, according to the official Libyan and U.S. news sources. However, it is not clear whether the protesters were the ones who attacked. U.S. sources given conflicting accounts about whether the attack was planned before the protest, whether the attackers used the protest as a diversion. Possibly. Was the attack planned? And were proper security measures in place? Again, good old Mitt Romney and his campaign. His campaign has the idea if President, should I slap myself now or can I do it later? If President Romney was in office, on the heels of the anniversary date of 9/11, all of the U.S. consulates around the world, that their security would have been tightened on the anniversary date. My nephew, one of them, brought up the idea that was several years ago what had happened, and that America should go on beyond that of what happened. More or less putting that in the back of our minds, and I think to some degree he was right. However, it does not necessarily mean that the United States, that we as a society, that we would turn our back on it and we would forget it, or ever would be able to completely forgive and forget and go on. Maybe that's his sentiment. But folks, I have to look at even 9/11 and for a movie as this, anti-Islam against the Prophet Muhammad, I've got to look at this and say, wait a second. The United States, we cannot be that vulnerable. But I do say this, that for the most part, Americans have been absolutely ridiculously stupid. Like it or not. I think that the U.S., the United States, could do far more when it comes to security. However, I don't think that Mitt Romney has the answers to it all either. I simply don't. I think that looking at the movie that is portraying what it did and that it is inside of the violence, that movie should once and for all be recalled, right? Never to be aired, never to be seen, never to be heard of again. Again, the producer, though, he had the right to voice his opinion. Now, a movie is based on one of three things, either fact, fiction, or opinion. And apparently, this movie was based on opinion and not on fact. And it doesn't necessarily fall into the category of fiction either. Now, too many people get so frustrated and so carried away on so many issues. And folks, those are the issues that divide people. We don't need division anymore. I honestly think that we need people that are in our midst. We need people in our land. We need people in the world that understand that an opinion is just an opinion. However, just because I may have an opinion doesn't mean that you have to agree with it. Just because Andrew, for a good example, may have an opinion doesn't necessarily mean that you have to agree with it either. Just because Zebulon Doyle, or just because Bill, when he came on, had an opinion, doesn't necessarily mean that you have to endorse or support that opinion. But we, this is where we as society, we as Americans, have become so stupid, so ignorant, because we look at everybody else's opinion and we draw our visions, we draw our goal, we draw our opinion off of the opinion of somebody else. We do. Rather than saying, look, if I want to agree with this or not, if I want to agree or not, I'm brainwashed. So therefore, I have no opinion of my own. I'm basing my action and my reaction based on what you say. Folks, I don't think that it is right to base an opinion, to base our opinion, necessarily on what other people say, but we need to be basing our opinion based on what we personally feel. These attacks, no, they were not justified in any way. Now, people can, they can argue their ball team is better than the next ball team. They can argue the point, and they can say, look, my newscaster is better than yours. They can argue the point. Our stream is better than your stream because we air Occupy. 24/7 Occupy, nothing more than Occupy. And because of that, hey, our stream is far superior than yours. Hey, we're a new stream. All right. And you know, it irritated people because they even wanted us here at the Robert Christian Show. They wanted us to be in competition with the Occupy Wall Street group. And again, I sort of laughed at it because I thought, wait, Monday is the first anniversary of the Occupy group. All right, that's flawless. And we soon are going to be celebrating our first year anniversary right here live. Hey, we've done a lot of things in the last year. We have done a tremendous amount of things in the last year, including doing fundraisers for the Occupy Wall Street group. However, that wasn't good enough. It wasn't good enough because they wanted us to be and to conform to their ideas and not challenge them. Folks, I have no problem with most of the Occupy Wall Street members. What I have a problem with is the challenge is a one-way street, and it has to be their challenge their way, rather than challenging the way that they feel, the way that they look at things, the way that they react to things. Now, what is the Occupy group going to do? This is a good question. What are they going to do when it comes time for you know, to protest on Monday? They're going to protest the original protest on Monday. Solidarity protest around the world, everywhere. Everybody's got to find a snail and watch across the road on Monday. Now, what is it going to take? Folks, this is, it's ridiculous. Again, the Occupy group, it in itself, its original message was one that I agreed with. The original message. But I do not believe, I do not support what it has become. Now, having said that, this movie, why isn't the Occupy group protesting this movie? Why not? Because you see, this this movie has incited violence and violent acts that never should be portrayed in anyone's backyard. I don't think that it's right. I simply do not think that it is appropriate. Now, what is appropriate, in my opinion, for what it's worth, is solidarity with the idea of hope, with the idea of a dream, that we, as humanity, would never again be judged by the color of our skin, but by the content of our heart. They were judged not by the disabilities that we may have in our body, that we are not judged by the color of our hair or the car that we drive or the neighborhood that we live in, but rather I have a dream as well, Doctor, and that is for all of humanity to be able to get along. I have learned some things about the Nation of Islam. But they, like any other group, they, like any other people, have the right to exist. But when do we, as Americans, when do we have the right to cause such backlash, hatred, in that way? I don't see it. Now, another unanswered question is this: what is the role of the film in all of this? Tuesday's protest outside the consulate, as well as protests 700 miles away at the U.S. Embassy in Cairo, Egypt, seemingly began because of the outrage over a YouTube clip from a film that portrayed the Prophet Muhammad as a womanizer, a buffoon, a ruthless killer, and a child molester. Islam forbids depictions of Muhammad, let alone insulting ones. An actress in the video, who asked not to be identified, told a local national news organization that she and the other actors had no idea that they were performing a movie about Muhammad. Lines about Muhammad and Islam were dubbed in after the movie was shot, according to what she said. The 80 cast and crew members released a statement saying that they were grossly misled about the film's intent. All right, this is what I was talking about. The entire cast and crew were extremely upset and feel taken advantage of by the producer, they said in a written and prepared statement. They said that they were shocked by the drastic rewrites of the script and lies that were told to them and all that were involved. We were deeply saddened by the tragedies that have occurred. The actress said that the character of Muhammad in the movie was named George when it was shot. Oh, okay, the name George when it was shot. But after the production wrapped up, she returned and read the other lines that may have been dubbed into this movie, and that apparently were dubbed into it piece by piece. So what happens next? Since Tuesday's deadly assault in Libya and protest by the same day at the U.S. Embassy in Cairo, demonstrators, both small and large, have been reported in Israel, Gaza, Libya, and Egypt, Yemen, Sudan, Morocco, Iraq, Iran, and among the Muslim and Indian-controlled region of Kashmir. So, look, this is a worldwide thing. This news article says that while some protesters say that they have not seen any of the online film, they were incensed by reports of the depiction of the Prophet Muhammad. Which leads one to the big question moving forward, will this outrage continue to grow? That's a good question, will it? Regardless of whether the attack on Libya had anything to do with the film, people angry about the movie have flocked to many U.S. embassies, and with the Muslim Friday prayers beginning today, there is some in question about whether that there there could be an escalation of violence. I don't know if it is the likelihood. I would say it is a possibility. U.S. Ambassador to Afghanistan, James Cunningham, said in Kabul. I hope the message gets out there in the mosque, and one will be of restraint. I know that there will be many messages like that because we've already been through this. In other places, the message will be more extreme. We hope that those places will be isolated as possible and that the people will realize that this work of a very small group of people who are able to use modern tech to spread what they do more widely. But it doesn't sound, represent anything that in reality happened. Except disrespect, that did happen. And overreacting to its own in a way, rewarding its own responding to this disrespect. Okay. Now, another big question is, what exactly will the United States do? And how will they respond to the attack? And what will be the response? And what response could have been diplomatic in terms, with some countries currently reeling from unrest, i.e. like Libya? We know that the United States is deploying, folks. I don't ever remember in my lifetime the United States government and our military doing this because of a movie. This says that we know that the United States is deploying warships and surveillance drones in its hunt for the killers of four U.S. diplomatic staffers. Okay, I can understand why that they would want to do that. And contingent of 50 Marines has arrived to boost security of the Americans in that country. Again, is this because of the movie? What do you all think? The move will give the administration flexibility, is what this news article goes on to say. However, President Barack Obama says that we will not waver in our commitment to see that justice is done for this terrible act. U.S. President Barack Obama said on Wednesday, and make no mistake, justice will be done. Folks, this is all over a movie. All over a movie. Okay, now, why? Folks, this is what I really would like everybody to chime in. This is what I want everybody to chime in on. Now, what does it take? What should it take for someone to decide that anger and that violence is the best way? That's the only way. The only way is to get violent and to cause havoc worldwide because of a movie. As if the world already is not a political tinderbox And now we have this. On the heels of 9/11. Doesn't make a lot of sense. I, folks, am persuaded to believe that the production of this movie and the release of this movie was not by mistake. However, the gentleman who did this movie, he had the right to do it. He had the right to go ahead and produce this and put clips of it up on YouTube, of all places. Not that YouTube is bad. There's a lot of very interesting things on YouTube. But knowing that, well, I don't know. Maybe this guy did not know. Maybe he did not know. Folks, that according to the Nation of Islam, depicting Prophet Muhammad is completely a no-no. You're not supposed to be doing that. And then saying that he was a womanizer and a child molester, and he was everything else that you could possibly imagine. And doing this, and I don't know, maybe the guy didn't know. What do you think? Folks, this is the Robert Christian Show. I invite you folks to let your friends and your neighbors know now that we are live and on the air. Folks, this is of vital importance. It really is. Vigil Ant, welcome. We are actually streaming today on two different streams. So I don't get a chance to pay attention too terribly much to today anyway, to both of the actual chats, but welcome. Let your friends and neighbors know that we are on the air. Use your Facebook, use your Twitter. That's what we always say. Now granted, I am quite appalled by what had happened. But I really wonder, what is the Occupy Wall Street going to do? Are they going to attempt to protest, march around this producer's house in Southern California that did this, that incited the violence, or that at least helped it? And if they do, what message is that going to bring? Is that going to do anything? Probably not. But the producer of this movie apparently has gone into hiding. Apparently he has decided, whoops, maybe he did. Maybe he said, whoops. I made a bad mistake. Whoops. And because of it, I'm going to hide. I'm going to duck my tail and I'm going to hide. But again, maybe this producer, maybe he did not know what the Nation of Islam and what their fundamentals are about it. Maybe he did. Maybe it was a deliberate attempt to have people look at the Nation of Islam in a much, much different way. Maybe. Maybe it was more or less to cause havoc. Like I said, the world is a tinderbox as it is, and we certainly do not need any more violence. I think that the world needs the message of hope, the message of understanding. Now, looking at Tehran, looking at Iran, looking at their government seeking nuclear weapons. That's been making the news, of course. We've all heard it. But you know what? There has to come a time that peace and the message of peace is shown, and not of war and of anger and of violence. There, we can be diplomatic. I think when it comes to international affairs, and I think President Obama has been diplomatic. But I would much rather have a diplomatic president sitting there in office than I would having someone that is so non-diplomatic but very problematic, representing the United States, maybe in a way that is not beneficial to the United States. Now, surely he is never going to speak for me. He is never going to speak and say anything that I really want to hear. Mitt Romney isn't. I don't necessarily support him. I salute him. I honor him for his ideas. But his ideas are not mine. President Obama, I salute him for his leadership and for his willingness to do as he has. But that does not necessarily shed a light on my personal ideas and my personal goals and or satisfaction. So again, you know, when people base their mind, their ideas, solely on what other people have said, it really leaves everybody in a lurch. Because then everybody becomes so stupid and so ill, so ridiculous. I don't have a mind of my own, so I'm going to listen to Rush Limbaugh. I don't have a mind of my own, and so because of that, hey, I'm open to be brainwashed. I don't have a mind of my own, so religiously I have to listen to what other people say. And believe that as the ultimate truth. And the ultimate satisfaction. Going to a church that teaches messages of hate rather than messages of unity. I've got to base everything that I know based on what other people have told me. Have you ever, and I want you to think of it, folks, have you ever thought of that? The people do this, they base their thoughts, they base their life challenge, they base their opinion solely based on somebody else. Maybe because of their distemper, maybe because they don't have a mind of their own and they want to be brainwashed. Hey, here's a fresh mind, go ahead and brainwash it. I've got an open pocketbook. I've got an open mind. I've got an open heart. So go ahead and hurt it. We live in an open society, so go ahead and threaten it. You know what? That's ridiculous. Again, folks, we may not like or agree with. We may not even understand the Nation of Islam, for that matter. But just because you may not understand it doesn't mean that you have no choice besides to have a movie like this and to do this. Yeah, I know that he has the right to his opinion, as do you. Folks, I like to challenge everybody. I like to know what they think and why. Because I'm not going to judge you. I'm not going to hate you because maybe you don't agree with me. Because it's good point counterpoint. And you never know who that you're going to be able to challenge. I was challenged years ago by one word. And that one word was Phanapi from Donald Ray, who's a dear pastor friend a long time ago. One word, Phanapi, find a need and fill it, is what it meant. And I was so enthused because, folks, that was one word spoken to me that was in season. That was one word that I needed to hear. And then, you know what? I then later came back to Donald Ray, and I made a declaration telling him, this is what I think. And you know what? I don't really care what you think about it. This is what I think. And his teeth like to hit the floor, and he said, you finally got the message. And folks, I've never been the same again. It's not that I don't care what other people think or what other people feel. Obviously, I do. But being the tinderbox that the world really is right now politically, we don't need messages in movies like this ever. And now the consulates around the world, U.S. consulates are you know, beefing up security. And rightfully so. But I feel sorry for these actors and actresses and these people, 80 people or so, that produce this movie. Because apparently, and according to the news report, that a lot of the verbiage was changed after the fact that the movie was actually shot. The scenes were shot, canned up, and not quite ready to go because they had to put new verbiage in there. Why didn't they do that? Why didn't this man do this? To say, hey, let's take a look at the Catholic Church. Let's take a look at the Baptist Church or the Methodist Church and their leaders. Let's poke fun at some of the old fogies, old tent revivalists. Why not expose some of them for what they did in their life? Oral Roberts. If I don't raise $3 million, God's going to call me home. And somebody actually believed it. But there wasn't a movie about it. But why not? We look at major Christian radio and television networks. Oh, sure, that could be a movie about it. Depicting this and their leaders for some of the things that they've been accused of, i.e. or charged with. Or accusations. Again, it's accusations. It is the conspiracy theory. Right? And look, I can understand and I can appreciate some that have conspiracy theories. But I am not going to get so brainwashed into it thinking, you know what, if it's not a conspiracy theory, it's nothing. Then we're not going to cover it unless it's a conspiracy. Folks, this is real. This movie is real. What these people did was real. But when it gained international attention the way that it did, come on. Come on, folks. This is ridiculous. So what did they know and when? So again, the question, who is exactly behind the attack and what was their motivation? What do you think, folks? The motivation. Maybe we need to have a motivational speaker. What do you all think? Do you think that would be appropriate? Please. You know what? I think the world needs a good motivation. But this movie, simply put, it's not a good one. It only depicts, apparently, or incites violence. And you know what? I personally would not spend $15 to go to a movie theater to go see that. For me, to go to a movie, it has to be something funny. It has to be something funny. I'm not into the shoot 'em up and beat 'em up movies. We hear enough of that in the news already. I want to see something funny. I want to be able to relax and have something that's going to bring at least a moment's joy in a movie theater, if I'm ever going to go. Because, you know, I would much rather have people be laughing. And I've said this, folks, over and over and over. I would much rather have people laughing and enjoying life for what life brings. Personally, from my heart to yours, than I would see anger and violence. Than I ever would see people crying. Than I ever would see, look, if I had the opportunity to help, then that's what I'm going to do. Yes, we've raised money for different causes, and it's worked. We've been there. This show, we have been there. We, you know, in my career in major media, even, I've been able to see an awful lot of things. Yes, I've covered news stories that I did not necessarily agree with. I've spun records on the turntable by artists that I may not have personally have agreed with them, or their stance on political or religious views. But I had a job to do. And sometimes we have to separate ourselves from the bad to be able to really look at the bad and the good. Folks, that's the pivoting point. And people did not understand that. That is the pivoting point. And that is, look, I could say, yeah, we support the Occupy. Yeah, we support this group and that group. The Boy Scouts, the Girl Scouts, the Red Cross, the Green Cross, the Blue Cross, the whatever. All right. Yeah, sure, we support all this stuff. Okay. Having said that, I like to get down to the brass tacks and the real McCoy of the story. Not base my the talk show on the baseline of oh my gosh, this is really bad, or oh, the baseline of this is just really good. I've got to look at it, the pivoting point, looking and exposing the good and the bad of both sides of the coin, and successfully being able to look at two coins at the same time. Folks, that is called finesse. And you've got to be a pretty wise crackerhead, all right, to pull one over on me. You really do. Not saying that it hasn't happened, but to say this. Folks, when we are challenged in our heart, just before break, when we are challenged, folks, in our heart, then our mind changes. The way that we look at things, back in the 60s, interracial marriage. Oh, please, that was a thing that just was not going to happen. And now we're looking at same-sex marriage in the United States. And a lot of the Republicans are saying, oh, that's never going to happen like that. Oh, for crying out loud, we certainly can't have same-sex marriage. Why not? And then the U.S. government continues to say, the lawmakers, well, let's leave it up to the states. They didn't leave it up to the states when it came to interracial marriage. It literally was an act of the Supreme Court that said that, yes, in fact, that it is legal. What about that? What about that story? What about that? A movie about the injustice, a movie about the inequalities. Not looking at any one person, but looking at an idea. Folks, everybody has ideas. Everybody does. But there is one idea, one vision, and that idea is going to become reality. And that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for people that are willing to have their dreams become reality. I'm looking for people that are willing to have their heart challenged, that the realities then that are in their heart change their mind and they see things in a different light. Folks, I am Robert Christian, your host with the Robert Christian Show, and we are going to take a short break. When we return, I want your comments. This is your opportunity, folks, to voice your opinion. And folks, we will be back. So whatever you do, don't go away.
Hey, folks, I'm Robert Christian with The Robert Christian Show. Join us Monday through Friday right here for The Robert Christian Show as we discover news, breaking news, politics, religion, you name it. Folks, we have an incredible opportunity, a dynamic opportunity right now to use social media at its best. So we invite you to use your social media, folks, and go to YouTube, type in The Robert Christian Show. Hey, we're also on Twitter. You can find us there at News Talk 2. Folks, we are everywhere. Visit us on our website, www.robertchristianshow.com, and see what we're about, folks. We have an incredible opportunity right now, and I want to encourage you to take this opportunity, folks, to get involved beyond the social realm of social media and get involved in your media. Folks, this is The Robert Christian Show, where your voice and your opinion, they matter.
And, folks, you can follow us on YouTube. Look us up at The Robert Christian Show, and also we are on Twitter. There we go. There's the hashtag Robert Christian Show right there. And absolutely, we are always looking for sponsors, folks, for the show to help us with our vision. And folks, let this show be a part of your day. And I, folks, trust me, I do take great pride in that. Taking great pride, folks, in presenting news, presenting ideas that is going to be productive. Wow. So having said that, folks, Wow. I want to know what you all, and if this movie that we've been talking about, if this movie was at a movie theater, one question. Would you pay to go see it? What do you think that you would get out of it? Do you think that maybe that your understanding of the Prophet Muhammad and the Nation of Islam, do you think that it would change for the better or for the worse? Would you go? And I'm asking you. Would you go and see that movie? Would you want to spend your money to go see a movie that apparently is depicting their leader as apparently a man without morals? Again, folks, we can look at this, and I really want everybody to think of it. Would you go see this movie? Simply because it was a good thing. Or would you go see it out of curiosity? For me, I wouldn't. I remember a city councilman from Seattle, and he said this after the attacks on the World Trade Center. He said, I will not fear my neighbor, but I will embrace my neighbor. And folks, that stands the truth. That resonates truth. I don't want to end up fearing anyone, but I want to embrace them. I want to embrace their ideas and uphold their ideas. That's the right thing to do. Although it is their opinion, it is their idea, it is their vision. But folks, what good is a message or a messenger unless there's a message? And what good is a message unless someone is there to hear it? I like to challenge everyone openly. Not to embarrass anyone. Not to cause strife or friction. No, because you know what, folks? That's not me. But to challenge the best of them, to challenge the way that people feel, what they think. You know, even my father-in-law, I ask him the same, you know, trust me, we get into it. I'll ask him what he thinks about something, and then I'll listen to him. If I agree with him or not, all right, that's sort of on the back burner. But I always ask him, okay, but why do you feel that way? What about this? Would this not be a better way? And folks, look, to the producer of this movie, would there not have been a better way to have addressed his understanding, his vision, his view of the Nation of Islam, for that matter, the religious group? Again, would you spend your money to go see it if it were in a theater near you coming this Friday? You know, it's funny because movies are always on Friday. That's when they're released. Coming to a theater near you this Friday. Don't forget. But this movie, as I understand it, and as that I see it, it is a the mission of it, the vision of it, is a mission and a vision that divides, and that makes other people look at maybe the Nation of Islam, that religious group, as if they are, you know, a laughingstock. Looking at their leader. Well, why don't they do the same thing about the Pope, for that matter? Oh, let's remember Pope John Paul. And no offense to anyone that is a Catholic. My aunt is a Roman Catholic. But having said that, they didn't poke fun at the Pope. They didn't poke fun at Herbert Armstrong. They didn't poke fun at Muhammad Ali, the boxer. They didn't poke fun at George W. Bush. Oh no. But they wanted to. Apparently, his idea was, hey, let's see how radical that we can be, and let's see what can happen with a movie like this. Hey, because I know that there's a lot of people that believe in Islam as their religious fundamental faith. But you know what? He had the right to his opinion. However, we may or may not agree with it. Now, I think that opinions where they really start cutting is when they start inciting violence. And when people say, you know what, I don't like your opinion. And because of that, I'm going to beat you senseless. I don't like your opinion, and because of that, I'm going to ban you out of the chat. All right. Again, the challenge, remember, to the Occupy Wall Street group. Monday, all of the streams. Unban everybody that you've ever banned, right? And just see what happens. Do you think that they're going to do that? Heavens to Betsy, I bet they don't. Now, I want folks to be challenged. Every day here on the show, it is a challenge. Because I like to get into your mind. I like to get into where you are, into what you think, and find out why. Because you know what? Every time that I challenge somebody, then I get challenged. Because I want to be able to have a mindset that is one that is willing to be challenged, one that is willing to be open to ideas. Because somebody else's idea may be the right one, right? It might be the right thing that I need to concentrate on. That's happened. I don't think. However, their movie like this is of any realistic value. Not to me, it isn't. Depicting anger just because you can say, hey, we're going to have anger. Let's, you know, an all-out riot. Haven't we learned enough already? Hasn't the world already seen enough violence? Come on, people. The day that we live in is not the world that I grew up in as a child. Technology has changed. People's minds have changed. People's attitudes have changed. The world around politics has so changed. Maybe it was me, but back when Jimmy Carter was a president, I remember listening to his inauguration on the radio. And that, although at that point I did not understand what all of it was about, I later did. And when I became a voting age, finally got there, voting age, where I felt that my vote really counted, where I felt that I could really do something in the political arena to help to shape the United States into a better place. Folks, we can do the same thing with the world, one person at a time. And it comes with the heart of a challenge, a mindset that it's okay to be challenged and not feel threatened. The Nation of Islam, I could only imagine what they're feeling as a result of this movie. And again, granted, the producer of this movie, he had the right in the United States, according to the U.S. Constitution, to be able to the freedom of speech, and to be able to produce this based on that. Granted, he had that right. But I don't think that anybody has the right, really, come on, to deliberately say something that is a deliberate attack on anyone. That's where I sort of draw the line in the quicksand there, right? Because you know what? Opinions are all right. They're okay. But when an opinion becomes something very evil, it's when it goes to hurt someone else or a personal attack. And from what I understand, this movie was nothing more than a personal attack on Prophet Muhammad. Now, to clarify, no, I'm not Islamic. I believe that they have the right, as with any other group, to exist and to do what they do, to believe what they believe, to worship the way that they worship. If the Prophet Muhammad is their Jehovah, if he is their the King of Kings and there's no other, and that's the way that they feel, okay, although I may not agree with it. It doesn't matter at that point what I agree with. It matters what they feel. It matters what their thought is. Now, when they get the opportunity to be challenged, to see things a bit differently, maybe then they will. However, it is not my job, it is not your job to judge them. And again, to go against their leader. You know what? There have been religious leaders since day one. There really has. And the producer of this movie, he could have gone and said, hey, guess what? We're going to cause a little headache among the Mormons. Oh, boy, could you imagine? Hey, we're fixing. We could have. The very first occupant of the White House, which is a Mormon, in the White House. So we're going to go back into Joseph Smith. And into some of that church's religious background, saying, hey, you can marry as many wives as that you want. It's separation of church and state. So, hey, therefore, you know, we actually did a show on polygamy. We did. That was talking about a fiery one. That was a fiery one. And I had explained that even the polygamist, we may or we may not agree with them. But by the constitutional right of the separation of church and state, they have the right to exist, right? They have the right to be able to worship. They have the right to be able to do as that they do as a religious oracle, if we want to believe it or support it or not. Now people are raising their eyebrows to the ceiling. I can already see it. Good. Folks, what is fair and what is right too often do not meet up in the path of life. What is fair, what we all would want, what we all would want to achieve versus our fundamental beliefs. Sometimes our fundamental beliefs are the way that we were raised, again, was based on someone else's idea. And because of that, there is fear in the encampment. If you don't believe like me, if you don't believe like my prophet, if you don't believe like my pastor does, guess what? You're going to die and burn and go to hell. If you don't want to protest military funerals, if you don't protest funerals of gay people, then according to our pastor, then you're going to die and go to hell and bust it wide open. Those kind of messages never should be told. Those kind of messages never should be explored on Sunday. But the reality is that we all can get along. We really can. Because, folks, if we can't get along here, what makes us think that we're going to get along there? Now, to you, wherever the there is, let it be there. So, folks, I want to be persuaded to believe that the producer knew fully well what he was doing. But maybe he did not pay attention or think in his mind that it would incite what it has internationally. Now, today is Friday, right? Today is Friday. Tomorrow is the Jewish Sabbath, Saturday. And then Sunday. I wonder if I could look into time a bit, about 24 hours or so. What kind of violence, what kind of more violence is going to be portrayed around the world as a result of this? Folks, that is asinine. That's ridiculous. Now, you may not like the people that live in Iran, right? You may not like them. They may not like you. But you know what? We can, when we cross bridges, you never want to burn that bridge, right? You never do. Because you never know if you're going to have to go back across that bridge again. Point taken. So, you may not like the Israelis, but they may love the United States. You may love the Israelis, right? But you may not like the Palestinians. Folks, in every generation, there is always someone or a group, something to hate. Back in the 60s, it was interracial marriage. Oh, we have to hate that. We have to hate the African Americans. We've got to cause all kinds of divide, national divide, on the African Americans. We've got to cause a lot of heartache, bestow a lot of anger toward them. And then it was the gay and lesbian population. And you know, in some countries, you can still be stoned to death if they find out that you're gay or lesbian. Having said that, I think that the new breed of people, the new group of people, which really isn't new, that a lot of people are beginning to hate, it is the gay and lesbian community. Sure. But a lot of churches, a lot of religious organizations, they take great pride in saying, this is how to hate. This is who to hate. And this is why. I.e., like with this movie. No, I haven't seen it. I don't even care to see it. But apparently, the script writers were doing all that they could to undermine the Islamic community and their leader, as if he was a child molester, as if he was a womanizer, if he was, you know, it's crazy. It's crazy. I want to bring people, everyone, into a solid frame of mind, right? And I want to be able to bring everybody into a realistic idea, in a realistic path. And folks, the path of life that we all take, it doesn't have to be one of anger, unless we choose it to be. It doesn't have to be a path of war, unless we choose our life to be a life of war. Look, what happened to serenity? Accepting the things that we cannot change. There are some things in life, folks, that we can't change. But you know what? What we do today is certainly going to demonstrate, be a good demonstration as to what we do tomorrow. So if our minds today are made up, our heart today is made up, that we are willing to accept a challenge, then you know what? Tomorrow, that challenge is going to come. And then, maybe we can be a better person for it. Does that make sense? Folks, if you have computer-related issues, maybe you have a virus, maybe you have malware, Andrew Epperson, the technologist, he has a fantastic offer, $19.99 for the month of September to remove viruses and or malware from your computer. So contact Andrew at andrew@thetechnologist.biz, and he will be able to help you. Hey, I trust Andrew. I know Andrew. Good guy. And he is I think he's a proud sponsor for the show. So yes, folks, we can be found everywhere. We're on Facebook. We're on YouTube. We're on Twitter. We're on Skype. We're everywhere. But we do need more people just like you folks that are going to be willing to help us to get the word out, the message out, by using your social media, your media circles, to let your friends and your neighbors know, folks, when we are live and on the air Monday through Friday at 10. Now soon, and I'm not really sure what time or when, but soon we are going to be changing the time of the live show. And I'm looking, sort of looking, about 3 o'clock or so p.m. Pacific time. Somewhere about that, maybe 4, and do the shows then, which in essence, that's going to do a lot of things. So that is a time frame that I'm actually looking at, of changing, this show to. Meanwhile, there is all kinds of ways, folks, that you can help to support, the Robert Christian Show. Visit us on the web at robertchristianshow.com. And of course, if you are there, then click on the live tab, right? There you can see the program. If you are there right now and you would like to chat in the chat, then click on the video box, right? Click on it. get a username. It's free. Get a username and start chatting with others. That is what it is about. So, folks, we I've got to end with a good note somewhere, because I like to encourage people. I like to encourage the masses and to see things differently, of course, and to challenge modern media, to challenge our media. Folks, this is our opportunity, our joint opportunity, to use social media at its best. And folks, we can do that. I want to do that. What about you? Are you really willing and ready, folks, to use social media at its best? If so, then folks, I would encourage you to do your part as well. So folks, we're going to take us a short break, and don't go away. Use your social media. Folks, we are back, and I want to thank everybody today for joining us for the show. Hey, one question. Do you have the answer? Okay, there are some... oh, this is great. This is something. In closing of today's show. Hey, this, trust me, I sort of laughed at it. Really, I did just a little bit, got a good chuckle. Do you remember, and how many of you can say yes, yes, yes? Hey, I do remember, this. When was... Do you ever remember sending out your first retweet on Twitter? And to whom did you send it? Can you remember back that far? Oh, boy. Now, talking about something that is that's awesome. The first retweet that you ever sent. Wow. Other news story, folks, as we are winding up, folks, two earthquakes in California, one 3.8 and one 3.3. Both strike near Eureka, California. That is Northern California. For those that don't know geography that much, that is where it is.
You're watching The Robert Christian Show.
All right, folks, have a great weekend, and I will see you all back here on Monday.